Hey guys, so I've had a lot of people on my server who have issues starting up in survival, or at least in multiplayer survival. So I thought that I would do a little video starting up on a server. I'm not gonna choose my own server because then I'd have to ditch ownership of all my stuff, and I kinda don't want to do that. Generally speaking, you want to have a server with as low a ping as possible. Because the higher ping, the higher latency between you doing something and it actually happening on the server, so it will make your gameplay suck if it's too high. So yeah, let's pick a server. Let's take the Atomic server. I've forgotten how long it takes to join a world when when you're not on LAN with it. Download takes time, loading takes time. Everything takes time. Alright, so I've just cut past the loading screen because I didn't have the patience to wait for it, and I doubt you have either. So usually on a new server you join, you only have one option, which is the respawn ship. Which some people make custom and these people haven't, meaning it could probably be a pretty crappy server to play on. Yeah, the reason I am against standard respawn ship is because I could technically, like many creepers do, point it at that base, speed up and just crash right into it, smashing everything, because this is a heavy ship. Personally, I've replaced the ship with a custom one, a small ship that weighs a fraction of the weight and gives you the materials instead to build the things that are on it, apart from the thruster, so you can set up a base somewhere. So yeah. But anyhow, basically once you start up, you will want to find an asteroid that isn't inhabited. Or at least don't have turrets on it, and start up there, because you will need ore. So being close to an asteroid is beneficial, plus you can hide on the side of it. If you're out in space, you will be spotted. Which, depending on the server, can be a really bad thing. So, since I don't have a scanner, or what's it called? Ore detector, I don't know what's inside this, but let's just hope that it's good. Okay, so someone has already set up on the other side of this asteroid. And since it's still a spawn ship, I'm not sure if they will be returning. But yeah, let's just set up near that hole up there and hope our new neighbors are friendly. I apologize for the way I'm speaking. I have allergies, yeah, basic allergic to pollen in heavy amounts, which we have at the moment because it hasn't rained for the past week or two. So my sinuses are full. It's fantastic. Yes, okay, so we found our asteroid and we put down our ship somewhat. Let's see if it has the stuff. So yeah, basically we got a semi-hull asteroid. This is great for mining in the beginning because you're relatively safe inside the asteroid. Usually, if you don't start up with a full spawn ship like this, you want to build the following items. Oh, come on. I hate this ship. You want a medbay, because without a medbay you will not be able to spawn the same place twice. You will have to choose respawn ship on your next spawn if you don't have that, meaning you lose ownership of everything. You want a refinery, and you want an assembler, because refinery refines the ore down to usable metals and minerals, and the assembler assembles them into components you need when you are building stuff. Because in creative, in survival, you will need, for example, I need steel plates to build this one. And if I have any metal, a standard, I'm not sure I do. No, I have nothing. at all. That means to repair that plate I'll need to go down and get some iron. Just as a demonstration. So yeah, and if you're not aware, you use T to pick up stuff. I believe it says that, yeah. Does. Okay, so we've got a little iron. I'm not sure if it's actually enough for the purpose at hand, but we got some. Oh. Yeah, as long as they're connected via conveyor, it doesn't matter which inventory slot you access, because it will. And though we got some iron ingots, now I can go in and produce, let's say, 10 steel plates, and it'll take the iron from the refinery and make steel plates, which I can then take out and repair my damage. Anyhow, most servers that have respawn ships have them set to despawn once they are. Once you log out, that means this is not your base, this is just basically materials. You will want to grind this ship down and make a base out of it. And I'll just... Okay, we got a person right over there, but let's hope he is friendly enough to ignore us. Because... Oh, come on. Right, let's just set up shop here, start a new station, and place a few blocks. We don't have to build these blocks in right now, they just need to be there so we can place our stuff on them. Which we are currently unable to because this... There we go. Also a tip, you can use the right mouse button with the drill in hand to excavate. That means you will drill much faster, but you will not get any ore for it. This is good for clearing out space for a base and making tunnels through rock into ore or whatever you feel like. There we go. Now we have 16 of those left. Okay. Now we want to set up skeletons for the things we want to have on our base. And as I said, we need an assembler. And yeah. We also want a reactor, because without a reactor nothing will be powered. And I am turning the one of the two slots towards the assembler that will connect it to the conveyor system. Where is our refinery? Because we also want one of those. Oh, let's see, this is a bit more tricky when you're playing survival. You can't place them so far away. We want to place this so that its inventory port is pointing towards our... Oh, come on, for the love of... There we go, inventory port right there. We want that pointing towards our our assembler. Which means we need to place it right about here. Again, because I want everything connected to the conveyor system. Now, finally, we want to set up a medical bay, because that is what will allow us to respawn. In case we die or whatever. If you don't have, as I mentioned before, if you don't have a medical bay and you die, you will have to use a respawn ship to come back, and that will mean abandoning... Oh, come on. Abandoning all your ownerships. And I need an interior plate to place that. Okay. It feels like the astronaut is really sluggish when moving. Right. Now, we don't have the materials to build all these at hand, so we will be cannibalizing our little ship. Oh, it also seems this is an easy mode server with a very large inventory, so this will actually be quite easy. Basically, we just grind everything down. Not sure how much inventory space we have. 4,000 it seems. And this becomes pretty repetitive because now we have to fly back and forth, grinding and building and grinding and building until you have transferred the materials you need from your ship to your new base. As I said, the respawn ship that you came in will vanish. It will despawn once you either log out or die. So transferring it gives you a permanent base, or at least as permanent as it can get. We also want to bring as many materials that as we can from here with us, but the main priority is transferring the stuff we need, just in case someone comes and decides to take our ship or whatever. Okay, this astronaut feels really, really sluggish. When you start building something, all the materials you have in your inventory that it can use will be transferred to it for use later when building. That means you can still store stuff in the skeleton of a new build object without actually having to build all of it at once. No. Oh, that's the rest of our iron ingots. No matter. Now we need to find the reactor, which is right here. Now first we want to take out the uranium. This will however set our ship adrift, because we just turned off power. So it will start floating away slowly but surely. And we also want to bring our cargo container with us. Right. That is basically it. Now we have a starting base once I'm done welding these, which can which is basically self-sufficient because we can refine and craft out of all the ores around us, and we can spawn here and we have power, etc. Now after you have done this, you want to focus on getting more uranium. You start with 0.5 kilos, which will last a bit but not long, and if you run out of power you're screwed. Because if you run out of power, your refinery goes down and you will be unable to make new uranium. And now we use the filter in the inventories and transfer the uranium to our new station. And everything is operational. Now we can proceed to... let's see, I want the pilot sheet and the gravity generator, so it's a bit more pleasant to walk around in there. Usually this process is a pain in the ass because you most of the time will have much less inventory space than you have here. Yeah, let's just place that here. There's the make it easier or more malleable to control the station, and also you can recharge your suit energy when you sit in the chair, which makes it more less hands-on than using the medbay to recharge. And our small cargo container. As I said, anything connected to these ports will be part of the conveyor network. That means even though I placed it behind everything, from this port I have access to the assembler, the refinery, and our small car container which we just placed. And let's see if we can find a spot for our gravity generator as well. That is a bit out of the way. There we go. And a... come on now. And there we go. That is basically an entire base right here. You have access to everything that you need. And as you can see, you have 53 minutes of fuel left, meaning you have 53 minutes to get more uranium. Except we are going to tune down the gravity generator, because as you can see, it uses 567 kilowatts. That is a lot of power. And our area isn't even near this big, so let's turn it down to, let's say, 50 times 50 meters times 50 meters. This is a little bit big, but it will leave us space to expand in. And also, let's tune that down to 0.5 G's. And there we go. We are now using 1/6 the power we used when we started, meaning we have 5 hours of energy now instead of 50 something minutes. And it's basically just taking it from there now. All you will do from this point on is go into the rod and mine and bring it back to the refinery and refine it until you can make a mining ship or something that'll speed up the process. As for this ship, you may want to grind the stuff down and put the objects into your cargo container, because you can use this to build new ships. Actually, I think this will have most of the materials you need to get started on that little mining ship, so yeah. That's it. This was my little attempt at starting on a multiplayer server. I hope it was useful. And yeah, thank you for watching, and if you have any questions regarding this video or space engineers in general, feel free to ask in the comments below, and I'll do my best to answer and help. So yeah, see ya.